In undertaking a recording in a professional environment, a good deal of skillful and tenacious preparation is involved.
You know, the key to it all, you know, people are always trying to get really good snare sounds, you know. And I think the most important element to me is the kick drum. You know, the kick drum, you know, it's really the meat, you know. I think the snare is more the potatoes. And, you know, you got your meat and your potatoes with your snare. Then maybe the hi-hat is more like, you know, the asparagus. You know, today I expect it's going to take a little bit longer because I really want to get it right, because you only make your first record once. You know what I'm saying? You only make your first record once. Let me know if that bubble goes too far out to the left there. Let me see.
It's usually worth waiting for.
I've never had anyone take this long to set up. I mean, he only has four drums.
Wow. As far as studio stuff, I'm probably quite a bit more experienced than the other guys. You know, the Gensler Lee Diamonds, I don't know if you remember that jingle. They called me in and I played on that. You know, I played, it was like a glockenspiel, but it wasn't really a glockenspiel, but it was this little bell tree thing, and I played on that.
How are we doing?
Lapdog's still setting up.
He's still setting up, huh?
Once this record, you know, goes platinum or gold or whatever it's going to do, then, you know, I might just redevelop my whole set, you know, because I'm sure there'll be some drum companies that will want to give me some equipment, and then I can just do what I want. And I, believe me, I have some ideas. Today, very important, I'm going to probably have to do this, you know, 7 or 8 times before we start tracking. Just because, you know, you only make your first album once, you know.
A snare, please.
Though often a repetitive process, recording requires a zen-like focus and open state of being, where ideas and inspiration can flow unimpeded, raising the art to a higher level of musical transcendence.
Yeah, Oz, yeah. I'm not really getting that in the cans.
I was just finishing with the floor tom sound now, and then I'll check the cymbals. So we basically just have some tones on the bass drum.
Is this on a track, a recorded track? Or?
No, we haven't actually recorded anything yet, Drew. We've just been working on sounds.
Just drum sounds?
Just drum sounds, yeah.
So here it is, guys. The first note of the first song of the first Electric Apricot record. What do you think about that? I hit the wrong tom. But, alright, ready? Are we rolling? Okay, here we go.
The man for man.
Share fishing.
Sorry.
Share what?
I meant to say vision, I said fishing.
Is everything cool?
Yeah, I'm good, man. All right.
Just seemed like we got off on a rough, rocky start there.
Hey, Oz, what number is the bass in?
Boss, your amp is just incredibly loud. It's killing me.
You guys okay?
Yeah, we need to turn the bass amp down a little bit. Like
down?
He's probably bleeding through all the drums, right, Oz?
Pardon me?
He's probably bleeding through all the drums, right? I mean, it just seems really loud.